Hello and welcome to Eclectic Classes. Today's lesson is on Profibus. This lesson is a part of Industrial Communication Protocol series in which we have already covered many protocols and standards like RS-232, RS-485, Modbus, HART and DeviceNet. If you have not gone through those videos, just go through them to have the basic idea of different industrial communication protocols. If you have not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications of my new videos. And if you like my video, please press the like button and share your views about the video. Now let's start with Profibus. Profibus stands for Process Field Bus. Profibus is an open standard industrial communication protocol. It's OSI compliant, widely accepted networking protocol, commonly found in process automation, in large assembly and material handling machines. Profibus supports single cable wiring of multiple inputs like sensors, pneumatic valves, smaller networks, complex intelligent devices, and operator interfaces. Profibus development was initiated by BMFT, German Federal Ministry of Research and Technology, in cooperation with various automation manufacturers in 1989. Currently, the standard is under the umbrella of PI organization. PI organization is responsible for standardization of both Profibus and Profinet technology. Profibus, along with Profinet, could be considered as the undisputed world leader in the area of industrial communication protocols. Popularity of Profibus could be understood by its nearly universal in Europe and very popular in North America, South America, Africa, and Asia. Features of Profibus. Profibus uses 9-pin D-type connector, which are impedance terminated at the ends. Number of nodes that could be connected on a single Profibus network is 32 without repeaters and 127 with repeaters. Distance supported, that is total network length supported, is 24 km with repeaters and optical fiber transmission. Data speed varies from 9.6 kbps to 12 mbps on a Profibus network. Message size could be 244 byte of data per message per node, with additional overhead of 12 byte, resulting in a maximum message length of 256 byte. Messaging is done by two mechanisms, polling and token passing. Profibus supports two types of devices. Master device controls the bus. When they get the right to access the bus, they can transfer messages without any remote request. These are also referred as active stations. PLC is an example of master or active station. Slave devices are normally input devices like input blocks, transmitters, sensors, actuators, etc. They can receive messages from the master. On request from the master, they can transmit messages to the master. They are also referred as passive stations. Profibus has three variants: Profibus DP, Profibus FMS, Profibus PA. Profibus DP, decentralized peripherals or distributed peripheral. Initially, all the IO blocks or peripherals which read and write the input and output from field were installed in the control room panels, and sensors were connected through wires from IO block to the field. It simply means all were centralized at a single location. With Profibus DP, IO block could be carried to the field and then sensors could be connected to the IO in the field itself. From the IO, information were transmitted through Profibus to the central controller in control room. Thus, we see the IO block or peripheral was decentralized as it was carried to field itself. Thus, it was named Profibus DP. Decentralization resulted in saving of wiring cost. Profibus DP allows use of multiple master devices in one network, in which each slave device is assigned to only one master. This means multiple masters can read inputs from any device, but only one master can write outputs to any device. Profibus PA, process automation. Profibus PA was designed as an alternative to hard or 4 to 20 milliampere current loop communication. In Profibus DP, the IO was carried to the field from which individual sensors were connected to the IO block by their individual wires. To simplify it, Profibus PA was designed and now all sensors could be connected to the single bus in field. Thus, using Profibus PA resulted in removal of the IO block from the field and individual wiring from the IO block also. Here, one additional element gets introduced in the circuit, that is the segment coupler, which acts as an interface between Profibus DP and Profibus PA. Profibus PA is used in intrinsically safe applications also. Profibus electrical interface. Profibus uses fiber optic or EIA-485, also known as RS-485, as electrical interface. Normally, we see a purple colored wire in use in Profibus network. Profibus passes information through digital communication in that purple wire using RS-485 standard. Profibus PA uses a variant of RS-485, which is IEC-61158-2 for electrical interface. The network topology used in Profibus network is a linear bus terminated at both ends. Stubs may be used in some applications. Stubs are the branch line from the main line. Profibus uses a twisted pair cable with shielding. Shielding is sometimes not provided in the cable used, which is an application specific case. Usually, Profibus cable is in use are shielded. There are two categories of cables used in a Profibus network, type A and type B. Type A cable is used when the transmission speed is greater than 500 kilobaud. Type B cable is used for short distances and low baud rates. Even in Profibus network, the maximum permissible data rate varies with network length. Here from this table, we can see that for a network length of 100 meter, 12 Mbps data rate is supported, while at 200 meter, the supported data rate reduces to 500 kbps. Further increase in network length reduces the supported data rate to 9.6 kbps. From this data, we can conclude that while designing a Profibus network, the concerned elements should be distributed across locations in such a way that our total length of the network is in the reasonable limit and our desired data rate is achieved. Communication in Profibus network. Profibus supports two mechanisms for communication, token passing and polling. Token passing. Token passing mechanism is used for communication between multiple masters on the bus. In this mechanism, a software token is passed between masters in ascending order. DAO, the physical topology, is a bus. Due to the token passing across the masters in a sequential ascending order, a logical ring is formed between them. During the power up of the network bus, the master with lowest station address commences the initialization and keeps the token with itself. A request field data link status is transmitted by the lowest order master to each station in an increasing address order. The token is passed to the first master station that responds to the transmitted message. The slave stations and the master not ready stations are recorded in an address list called the gap list. Post-initialization, the token is rotated among the masters. When a token is received by the master station from the previous master, it gets the right to pass messages to the slave as well as other masters. Polling method. The polling method is used for communication between master and slaves by a master that currently has the token to communicate with its associated slave devices. A Profibus network could be of following types: only master-master system, that is pure token passing system; only master-slave system, that is pure polling system; hybrid of master-master and master-slave system, that is both token passing and polling system in the same network. Devices connected on a Profibus network could be of following types: DP Master Class 1, DPM 1. This is typically a PLC, Programmable Logic Controller. DP Master Class 2, DPM 2. This device are used for programming, configuration or diagnostic. DP Slave A. This is typically a sensor or actuator. Data transfer between DPM 1 and DP Slave. During system configuration, the user assigns the DP slaves to a DPM 1. During parameterization and configuration phases, the assigned slaves configuration data is fed into the DPM 1. Post feeding of the configuration data, each slave device compares its real configuration with the received from the DPM 1. Both the configuration information, that is configuration fed into the DPM 1 and actual configuration, has to be identical. This step of comparing configuration data safeguards us from any configuration faults. Post successful checking of configuration data, the slave devices enter into the data transfer phase, and the data transfer occurs as shown in the figure. That is, DPM1 sends the request frame consisting of data with header and trailer sections to the DP slaves, and immediately in response, the slave sends the response message with data and header and trailer sections consist of information for addressing, error checking and other protocol related information. With this, I conclude this session on Profibus. Hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and share the video among your friends. I'll be back soon with another video. Till then, keep watching and keep learning. Bye and thank you.